did you say nothing? Hang on, Jim. Sarge, it's Jim Carver on the phone. He says the neighbour knows nothing.
Come on, she's the one who made the complaint.
Hang on, Jim.
I'll have a word.
Sergeant Penn is coming over. Hold on.
Oh, yeah,
Sergeant,
yeah.
No,
can you hold on a minute? No, look, I'll have to ring you back. It's no good.
Right, well,
it's like a bloody man.
I'll ring you back in a minute, all right?
This is the third time I've complained.
I can understand how you're feeling. You see, the thing is, if your neighbours own the house and choose to keep a goat in the garden, there's nothing we can do about it.
But it's causing criminal damage, for God's sakes. It took my late husband years to get those rose bushes.
One licence, one current MOT certificate, and one insurance cover note.
Sorry, Mr. Sarge, I'll just get the details.
All right, I'm sorry about that.
The juice. Half an hour, no more.
Oh, well, why not? Everything else is happening today, isn't it?
It can't be helped, Chief. I can't miss about a bit live.
Sarge, heavy transport notification.
Oh, good. Glad they're keeping you busy.
Yeah, I know he gets results. You only have to look at the records for that.
So what are you saying,
it's then? The way he gets them that's wrong. It's his attitude. We talk to people. We treat you, me, everyone.
Look, there's an old saying. Don't judge me on the way I do the job. Judge me on the results.
Oh, bullshit. We're police officers, not sales reps.
Look, if the super lets him get away with it, then there's not a lot we can do about it.
Bloody super, all he wants is a quiet life, getting his foot in the next rung of the ladder. That's all that bothers him. Admin and bloody politics.
All right, that's Daddy's plumber. I want him lifted. Better take some backup. There's lots of bit of trouble.
What shall I stick on the sheet, Gov?
Just pick him up, Ter, all right?
Yeah, but what's the charge?
Detective Inspector Galloway.
That's a call for him, Inspector.
Okay, love, put him through. All right, Ted, just do it. Leave me to worry about the details, all right? Yes, Conger. All right. Where and when?
Sarge, what am I going to do about this?
The lady's waiting.
Thank you.
I'm sorry about that, Mrs.
Oh, that's all right. I've got all day, haven't I?
Right, thank you very much, Mrs. Symes.
And a cover note.
Sorry.
Oh, just as I want to see.
No,
I'll go and get the car.
You know the power's going off?
Not upstairs this night. What are you on about?
They're turning off the electricity for about half an hour.
Yeah, well, as far as I'm concerned, they can turn it off forever.
Excuse me.
Another satisfied customer. Hey, you're not being well pissed off. What's up?
I'll give you one guess.
Oh, not his nibs again.
Yeah, well, I can't think of a better name than that for him. Listen, I promise you, I will lose my pension over him. You know, one of these days, I'm just going to lose my rank and slap one right in his bloody jaw.
John! Will you get upstairs? Tell him the power's going off for about half an hour, will you?
Right.
I promise you, I will, Bob. Yeah, no, he's bloody impossible.
All right, I know. Give him some time. He'll come to terms with it.
Come to tell, he's had 3 months, for God's sake. Come, you know, he's not the first policeman to ever been
so
divorced.
You don't get over 15 years of married bliss in just 3 months. I leave it, right?
Hello, Mr. Farmer. Long time no see.
Sorry. I think you have it mixed up with someone else.
Beg your pardon, sir.
I'm telling you. You fit, Mike?
Yes.
She's gone, Sarge.
Yeah, I noticed.
All right, let's have a look. Right. A goat? Yeah. I tried to explain to Mrs. Beck that there's nothing much we can do if the neighbours own the property. There's no law against owning a goat as a pet, is there, Sarge?
Well, as far as I know.
Still, sounded like she was getting the runaround of this.
Beat four.
Hello,
yeah, there's Martella, isn't there?
Never mind all that. When is she coming home, did they say?
In a few days, the doctors reckon. Mm. Gives me a bit of a chance to clear the place out. Get rid of all the loose women. Looks like a bomb in it at the moment.
You're all the same, you men. Hopeless without us women.
Oh, here we go.
It's true.
Get away with you. Yes, me darling.
I'll better get moving. I'll see you.
Yeah, me slippers ready about half one, all right?
Oh, yeah.
I'll see you too. Give me regards to the missus.
Cheers, son.
How are you then?
Oh, I've seen you for ages.
327 to Sierra Oscar, receiving you. Over.
Open this up, Baz. They tend to want to be another Indian takeaway.
Jim, will you assist with the spot bother I've got to follow up?
Well, something that needs a manually.
So what are you telling me now, then? That this place is going to have to be shut down completely?
It'll only be off about an hour, Chief.
Half an hour, you say?
Yeah, well, it's not that simple.
All right, so what are you saying? 2 hours? 3 hours?
No, it shouldn't be.
Look, I've got to add the power through to the street charge rack for the personal radios. That is a must. I just can't have it out of service, that's all. Excuse me. Can you rig up a temporary line?
Yeah, well, it just means more work.
Oh, I'm sorry about that, but it's going to have to be done.
No.
Have you checked the vehicle registration?
Yeah, and it is kosher under the name of Symes.
All right, look, leave it with me. I'll get back to you on this.
OK, Sarge. Yes, sir, can I help you?
Sergeant Cryer, please.
What name is it, sir?
Littleton. Abel Littleton.
Right, I'll just get him for you. Man, you are Sarge.
Sarge. This is the Yorkie Bar Kid here. Bob. You might have a ringer there.
Bob, me. I'm off out for an hour. Roach and Dashwood are bringing a Danny Plummer. Bame in a cell till I get back.
Yeah, so is it a sticker or what?
No, just a questioning. Sarge, there's somebody to see you.
Yeah, well, hold on that for a minute, eh?
Well, yeah, first of all, can I
think young Sherlock might have something.
Elementary, my dear Sarge.
42?
Well, here.
Yes, P.C. Littleton.
Oh, you're a day early.
Well, I thought I'd pop in and introduce myself. Have a look around.
Yeah. Yeah, why not? Well, welcome to Sun Hill.
Looks peaceful enough to me, Mrs. Beck.
Oh, it's peaceful enough, young lady, but you just look at this. Look at that. Took my late husband years to get that to bloom. That bloody thing keeps eating it.
Oh, I have tried next door, Mrs. Beck, but there's no one in.
Eats anything and everything it does. It stinks as well. There should be a law against keeping him in a garden.
I'm afraid all we can do, Mrs. Beck, is try and have a word with its owners.
Out of them two. A pair of bloody hippies they are. Spend half their time on another planet, if you ask me. Flower power and all that rubbish.
Well, we'll call back later and try the neighbours again.
Have you tried the environmental officer down at the town hall?
Town hall?
If I'm in the wrong place, Conger, I'm going to kick your ass. Then if I am, you won't hear me, so it'll come as a nice surprise.
Got away with words you have, Mr. Galloway. How's your luck?
Plenty of it, all bad. This is a piss hole.
Nice and private, though. Step into the office.
You got something for me or what?
Get the pound notes out, Mr. Galloway. It's a right good one.
Come on in.
A tunnel job, a bank, on your patch. Interested?
Depends. Ha! Don't take the piss out of me, my old son. Well, me and you are going to fall out, understand?
Oh, I understand, Mr. Galloway. You know me. I wouldn't do that.
You'd do anything.
That's not nice. That's not nice at all.
You coming across? Or am I going to have to do you for wasting my time?
All right. Two names. Frank Parry and Denny Lamb.
Where?
And the rest. What about the rent? Got to be a good payer, a bank job.
You slimy git. What's the use of two names? Come on!
And finally, our guest rooms.
Ooh, we do get some charmers. Look at that.
So I see him.
Right. Turns out we got another guest.
Excellent. Okay, give us a hand.
Get off of me! Oh, you can't see the slags! Go on!
No, but I used me charm on him. Be a copper and see the world, they told me.
Oh, Mike,
Can you have a word with Sergeant Penny and Yorkie Smith? Yorkie will tell you all about
it.
Okay, Bob.
Come on, let's go get ourselves a cup of tea.
Good idea.
Sergeant Tossers! Where's he going?
Shaggy little creature with horns and legs.
Yeah, and it was a little evil, was it, Jim?
Well, I wouldn't fancy getting on the wrong end of it. Well, they sent me wellies, of course.
But we used to keep goats. The milk makes great cheese.
Young goats are nice to eat.
I think that's what's on the bleeding menu today. Look at this lot of old tripe.
Sit down and join us, why don't you?
Kid.
Hey.
Young goats are called kids. A lot of people eat kids.
Look what the sergeant's just brought in. Have to come, I suppose.
Tact's never been one of your strong points, has it?
All I said was
yeah,
to
heard
come.
Exactly what you said.
Right. PC Abel Littleton. WPC's Viv Martella.
Hi.
June Ackland.
Hi.
And PC's Taffy Edwards.
Hi.
Jimmy Carver.
You do,
and Yorkie right. Smith. Right. One feeding his fate is Pete Muswell. Sit down, then.
Thank you.
Oh, Yorkie. Mike Dashwood's downstairs having a word with Sergeant Penny about your Mr. Silence.
Oh, right, Sergeant. Have it to pop down then.
It's your show. I'll leave you with it, all right? But pop in and see me before you leave the building.
Right, Sergeant. Will do. Hi.
Right.
Bye. Now that's over with.
You're right with Sarge, Abe. He's one of the best.
Yeah, he's right.
Excuse me.
Excuse our friend.
One out of six of you ain't bad, I suppose.
Oh, no. What is going on in this place?
I took him for Peter Farmer. You know, the chap who had the pub down in Grove Road.
That's where I know him from. And you, I knew him, Sarge. You used to drink in his boozer after work.
Yeah, which boozer? Oh, that's a Barton Arms. Yeah. I used to drink them myself when I was stationed at Bow Road. Look, what's the address on his brief?
Herbert Road.
No, his mother used to live in those flats, not him.
All right, thanks, Mike. Any idea what this is all about?
Yeah, afraid so, Sarge. I've got an idea that he's had his licence suspended for 5 years. Second time up for drunk driving.
All right, thanks, Mike. Right there, young Sherlock.
Where's Ted?
Better get the wheels in.
He's up in the canteen, Gov.
Get him, won't you? Both in my office at the double.
All right, Gov.
Frank?
Yeah?
This thing don't seem to be working.
Oh, look, go check the fuse on the temporary line, all right?
And you've done that.
Yeah.
What's your first impression?
He's bright, sharp. Good sense of humour. That's about all I can say at this stage, sir.
Yeah. This is his third posting in 3.5 years. Seems to have a bit of a problem settling down.
Well, I'll keep an eye on the situation, sir. Can't be easy, can it? Being a minority within a minority.
No, it can't. Look, Bob, let's not mince words over this. Constable Littleton gets no special treatment.
Well, of course not, sir.
I mean, either way. Like you say, he's a minority within a minority. If I find that he's subjected to any form of internal racial bigotry, I'm going to have the offenders out of here in a flash.
With all due respect, sir.
I know that I don't need to tell you.
No, sir.
Good. I'm sorry, but it had to be said from the off. I want everybody in this building to understand the score. And for this station to succeed where all the others have failed. I'll leave that in your hands, Bob, all right?
Very good, sir.
Right, thank you. Thank you, sir. Get me DHQ, Commander Lane, please.
Yes, sir. This is Detective Inspector Galloway from Sunhill Police Station.
Police?
Yes, sir. Firstly, could you look in your file and find this station's number and call me straight back, please? Well, yes, sir, I could give you my number, but I want you to be sure of my identity. Yes, it is, sir. Fine, thank you.
Burke, right. Who's ready for a bit of excitement, then?
Well, I think our Mr. Plummer was enough excitement for one day ago.
Come on, Tex. I told you he liked a bit of aggro. You're getting a bit old, aren't you?
He's down in the cells. Not a happy chap.
Well, bleeds for him. Right, forget about Plummer. Something more urgent to come up. Ted, I want you to get onto this firm of estate agents and find out who's got the lease on the empty shop in Queen's Parade.
And Mike, I want you to...
CID, DS Roach. Says he's a bank manager.
Tom. One moment, please.
Come on, let's have some action.
Now then, sir.
Don't say it, Ted.
How the hell can we work as a team when we don't know what the bloody hell is going on?
He'll put us in the picture soon enough, I suppose. Ours is not to reason why.
You're talking like a prat, Mike.
Ours is to reason why. All right. All right, you said your piece. Look, if you don't like the way the governor does his job, then go in there and tell him. But just get off my back, all right?
CID, DS Roach.
Yes, sir. It's the fourth on the left, past the roundabout. Yeah, that's the one. OK, cheerio. Sarge, is it all right if I nip out for him?
Yeah, of course.
Shouldn't be long, Bob.
At least it's quiet with Injun Brackett out at lunch.
What I can't understand is why they had to turn off all the juice and then go out to lunch.
That's to show us that they're still in touch with current affairs.
You are?
Never mind, Tom. I'll see you later.
Fine then, son. Let's go and see our Mr. Farmer. Oh, Bob.
Yeah?
I do worry about you sometimes, you know, all that deep thinking. Can't be good for you.
What would you know about it?
Get stuff.
Hey, what are you two doing here? Should have been out on the beat 10 minutes ago.
Well, yes, Sarge, but we were quarter of an hour late getting in, Sarge.
Yeah, a likely story. Did you sort out that Mrs. Beck complaint? You know, the goat thing?
Yeah, we called round, Sarge. The owner of the said goat was out.
So we called back this afternoon, Sarge?
Right, well, on your bikes, then.
Oh, Sarge, could you get comms to run a vehicle check on this registration
number? No, I think I could manage that. Reason?
Well, it's a Ford Transit open backed, and the registration number on the textis doesn't correspond with the vehicle.
Let's have a look. I'll get it checked out and I'll give you a call. All right?
Oh, sorry, thank
you. Off
you
go.
See you.
Oh, hello, Brian. How are you? How are they treating you over DHQ then?
What's your about beer? Not too bad, thanks. Urgent photos for D.R. Galloway.
Has he been going around the back door again?
You know him, Sarge. Any dodge to get what he wants.
Yeah.
I'll see you.
Sir.
All petty stuff.
From Acorns.
Yeah, but first the Acorns have got to fall. And these two are going to fall, all right? Right. I want you to get onto the Civil Engineers Department at the Town Hall. I want a complete set of plans covering Queen's Parade.
All right, Dan.
And Mike.
Yeah?
If they ask you any questions, use your charm without giving anything away.
How come I give anything away, Gov? Don't know what's going on.
Right, Ted, what you got?
Not a lot. The property is up for let. Been on the market now 6 months.
Owner?
Mr. Brayinski, but he's out of the country and has been for some weeks. Listen...
Did they say anything about the owner employing builders, decorators, anything like that?
No. Look, with the greatest respect...
All right, just arrived.
Great. Things moved a bit quick this time.
Oh, sorry, Ted.
No, I'll be my guest.
Ted, I want you, Mike, Chris and Jim ready for a briefing in 10 minutes and call your wives and lovers, you're all on overtime.
Cheers, sir.
Anything we should know, Roy?
Thanks for the delivery, Robert.
Oh. Lone Ranger alive and well and living in Sunny Old Nick, is he?
You'll be informed if and when.
Wonderful.
Oh, by the way, what are you going to do about your Mr. Plummer? Can't hold him much longer without a charge, you know. Well, he assaulted Ted Roach, didn't he? Charge you with that for now. Nip around the side, see if there's another private entrance.
Right, Sarge.
Yes.
Good afternoon, madam. Is Mr. Farmer at home, please?
No, he's not here at the moment. Can I help you?
Mrs. Farmer, is it?
Oi! Oi! Stop! Oh, damn!
That's all I can tell you, I'm afraid.
Thank you, Mrs. Farmer. Please don't shut the door, love. I'll be back in a moment.
Quick, Sarge, he's doing a runner!
Did you get the reg?
Yes, Sarge.
Shall I keep you a moment, madam? This is not the movie, son, and we are not Starsky and Hutch. Now get on the air and pass to all units.
But, Sarge...
Quickly, lad. He won't get far. Besides, pound or penny, he'll get 3 miles down the road and realise he's acting like a wally. Oh. Do we want to play dodgems, then?
Once they're through this flank wall here, it's only a matter of digging through about 12 and a half feet of clay and they're directly below the vault floor. It's that simple. Any questions?
Yeah. Do we know how they intend getting up through the vault floor?
Well, we can only make an educated guess at this stage. I've received no information on that, but I would say they'll attempt a series of small charges Frank Parry has formed with explosives.
When do we go in?
It's tricky. If we go in too early, our friends could duck any real charges. I think we've got to let them dig away until they're right under the money.
Has the bank been informed, Gov?
I've spoken to the bank manager personally. I've got a meeting with him a little later on.
Do the uniform lads know the score yet?
Not yet. For the moment, I want to treat this strictly as an obo number. I want everything to stay and look nice and normal. I don't want our little firm being frightened off.
Firearms, Gov?
No, right, that's it. Ted and Mike, you take the first turn as of now. Jim, get that cleared up. Ted, I want to see you in my office. Having already spent some time down on the site, I think the best place for you is here. And if Mike sits there, you'll both have good views of the shop front. All right?
Yeah, but we won't have a visual on each other. Now, if I sat here and Mike sat here, then we... No, with all due respect, sir...
I haven't got time for a debate. Christ. What's up with you lately?
What's up with me? Oh, that's bloody good coming from you, that is.
Now, come on, look.
That's
bloody marvellous. What is all this about?
Do you really want me to tell you, Inspector?
Oh, don't.
Do you?
Ted.
An hour, the man said.
Even half an hour?
Sorry, Chief. It's a bit more involved than I first figured.
Well, how much longer is it going to be now?
Half an hour should do it.
No, still no lights. Listen, any report on our Mr. Farmer?
No, not as yet.
What's up with young Sherlock?
He wanted to play races around the houses.
Oh, dear. Vehicle check, Sarge.
Thanks, love.
Do you want me to raise him?
Yeah, it's worth a try.
600 from Sierra Oscar, receiving, over.
600, receiving, over.
Jim, that vehicle check of yours, the transit belongs to Frank Parry, but the original disc related to a vehicle registered in the name of Dennis Lamb.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra Oscar 5, are you receiving? Over.
have their guts for garters. I know Bob told them about it.
Cheers, Sergeant.
Watch your feet.
Okay, all right, lad, yeah, you take it easy.
All right, good morning. Good morning, Sarge.
PC Littleton.
Well, nice and peaceful in here this morning. What's up?
What's your number?
Bob, 3-4 the recharge unit's been out all night.
Good morning.
Left downstairs, though.
Thanks, Sarge.
Good to remember.
Yeah, it's a bit of a worry, yeah.
Well, how the hell did it happen in the first place? I got those comedians to rig up a temporary line.
Search me. All the radios are flat. About bloody time.
Morning, sir. Sleep well, did we?
Shut your face.
My sarge asked me to give you an early morning call.
Right, little comic, aren't you? What do you call this?
How about morning tea? Sorry we run out of papers.
I'm entitled to a sodden breakfast.
We don't have that sort, I'm afraid. Only English or continental.
Get knotted. I know my rights.
We've all got rights, but we get what we get, though, don't we?
Stupid Welsh git.
The prisoner's welfare, like everything else, see? Cut back.
Stop that. I put in a complaint, mate, and I want Galloway.
Grilled or scrambled?
They stayed in the pub until closing time.
Did you go in?
No, Governor. I didn't want to risk being recognised. The governor of the pub knows me.
Right, go on.
They left the Monk's Head at about,
half past 11.
About half past 11?
11:23.
You've got soap on your forehead.
Thank you, Governor. Lamb then dropped Parry off at his place at 11:45, and I followed Lamb back to his place, arriving there at 12:04.
Home to bed like good little boys, eh?
Yeah.
Don't go, Ted. I stayed outside Lamb's place, watching the van, until 2 a.m.
Yeah, I stayed on over outside the site until 2 a.m. And no one came near the place.
Who's down there now, Jim?
Yeah, I've just been in touch. All's quiet down there.
Right. Mike, back out and relieve Chris, watching the van. Any sign of activity, get in touch. Ted, back down the site and relieve Jim. I'll be down there myself a little later on.
And I'll relieve myself first.
All right. OK, so now that you're all aware of the situation on radio communicators, we'll move on. Welcome, please, first, to a new member of our team, PC Abel Littleton. Welcome to Sunhill. Now, as usual, I will expect every member of our squad to extend every help and assistance necessary for a speedy and uneventful settling in period for our new colleague at arms. All right? Okay, moving on. Foot patrol changes for the day. 4 beat. Oh, yes, where a certain Hector the Goat is causing some concern. 210 Muswell, 643 Ackland. I think you could go out together on this one. Well, it's kid stuff, isn't it? It should suit the pair of you. Now, the complaint has been dealt with by the night shift, and the owners of the said goat have been interviewed. However, when you're passing 114 Lee Road, just check with Mrs. Beck to make sure that everything is all right. OK? 5 beat. Oh, yes. 600 Carver. I'd like you to take out 342 Littleton with you today. Show him the beat. Mind you, he might be able to teach you a thing or two at the same time.
Which?
Oh, and Queen's Parade. That's on the borderline between 4 and 5 beats, Carver. You could have another look for your 4 transit. You never know, you might get lucky. On the other hand, you might not.
Julia, it's me. It's Dad.
Dad?
Yeah.
Just to say hello, you know. How are you? No, Julia, don't call your mum yet.
Hello?
Sorry to call you so early. I didn't get you up, did I?
Of course not. What do you want,
Roy? I just got the divorce papers through this morning and I just thought we ought to talk.
You want to talk?
Kate. Please. What is it?
I'm not sure, Mr. Plummer. We got him banged up still.
I'll be down in 10 minutes, all right?
Cell or truth room?
What?
What, do you want to interview him in a cell or in one of the interview rooms?
In the cell.
Fine. You all right, mate?
Yep. Fine.
So your best
probably
gonna be
good.
She'll
eat you alive, Sunshine.
She doesn't, I certainly will, the pair of you.
It weren't our fault, Chief. The fuse on the temporary line blew. We hadn't anywhere, no.
How do you sniff? Anyone?
Oh, come off it, Pete. You couldn't have made it more obvious. What about yesterday in the canteen?
Look, just because I wear a uniform don't mean to say I ain't got my own opinion.
But it's a private opinion. It should be kept to just that in this job. Private. You should have learnt that by now.
Look, you'll have to get used to it.
Oh, what's
the problem? Not prejudiced, anyway.
Oh, my God, you can't. You better come quick, it's that blooming goat again. It's gone off its rocker.
Oh, you must be Mrs. Beck.
That's right, dear. It's that blooming goat.
Expect
that
child of it too, being banged up in a cell all night.
And you mightn't be warm, Bandit, please.
It's all mouth, if you ask me.
Yeah? You caught Ted Roger nice one, didn't
you? More by nuts than by judgment. Room service!
Come on, stop messing about, Taffy. We've got a lot to do in there.
Compliments to the chef. Breakfast for Mr. Plummer.
I warned you, didn't I?
There's some of piss on you!
All right,
bloody maniac.
Come on, get it cleared up.
And what about me, Sarge? My shorts.
Come on, first things first.
Have you talked it out with him?
We're not exactly talked, if you know what I mean.
Because, you see, I honestly
My
do
husband's
think...
My had words with him.
It's a matter of gaining his confidence, Jenny. How old is he?
43.
No, I mean your son.
That woman next door's called them again.
Hey, no problem here. Nice police people, no problem.
Well, that's not what your next door neighbour tells us, sir. She says there is a problem, for her, at any rate. It's only our goat. There's nothing to worry about.
Mind if we take a closer look?
Feel free. My home is your home.
Yeah, I mean in the garden.
His name's Hector. It's a bit of a fancy name for a goat, isn't it?
He was a Trojan warrior in an earlier life.
Come on, Wilson. There's a nice boy. Come on. Come on, my beauty. Come on. Shit.
Watch it!
Now, listen, Hector. I don't want to hurt you, right?
Don't you believe it, Hector. I reckon he fancies you.
This ain't funny, right?
Here, I hope you're not hurting that goat. Don't you
come
hurt
on.
Him.
He's only trying to be friendly.
Well, if you can't do better than that,
you're in dead lumber.
You got me shivering in my boots, Chief.
Who was she?
Who you on about now?
This old slag you're supposed to be knocking off.
Not with you.
You said, on the night in question, you were shacked up in bed with a mystery. Okay. Who was she? What's her name?
Oh, yeah, that's right, I was. Can't tell you who, though, Chief. A married woman, see? Wouldn't be right if I did. Know what I mean?
And what would rubbish like you know about what's right, eh?
Be fair, Chief. You know how it is. I mean, I may well have been your old woman I was humping.
You bastard! Leave me! You bastard! Kill him! Leave me!
Enough!
Leave it, nutter!
You shut it!
Enough. I'm looking for that!
I said shut it!
Superstar, then.
Lovely night, sir. It's Ben.
Ackland and Muswell just phoned in. It appears that Hector the Goat is at it again.
Oh, good.
Yeah, call for a vet to calm him down.
Oh, joking.
No.
Vet's on his way.
When were you born, then? The sunshine state of Hackney, my son.
Really?
So what made you join the police force? What's this, the first round of Mastermind?
Sorry.
It's all right. Everyone asked me that. I joined because I wanted to do something worthwhile. You?
More or less the same reasons. Oh, come on, there's a transit I want to try and nab.
What's the problem here? He looks peaceful enough, doesn't he?
Yeah, you should have seen him half an hour ago, mate.
Why don't we just leave him, OK? Well, we'll look after him, he's fine.
I'll give him the old once over, now I'm here. See how he is, eh?
Oh, watch yourself, mate.
Hey, Hector. You're not supposed to be eating
the neighbour's garden, mate. Come on.
Come on. Come on. Ooh. Ah.
Would you believe it?
He obviously didn't fancy you. Is he all right?
I'm not sure. What do you feed a monitor raw?
Cabbage spuds.
Yeah, usual stuff.
Needed all this?
Yeah, he was scoffing the lot when we got it.
Hello, what have we got here? Tasty, isn't it?
I don't believe it.
I'm afraid so. Poor old Hector here is as high as a kite.
Any idea where your husband might go, Mrs. Farmer? Look, love, the longer the situation goes on, the deeper your husband sinks. He's only making your situation worse.
He'll be sent to prison, won't he?
Oh, well, that's not for us to decide, love. Now, we've checked with his mother. She's not seen him.
He has a sister living at Barkingside.
Mm.
He'll probably go there. Oh, what a mess.
Her address, please.
16 Endcote Street, Barkingside. I tried to stop him when you called round earlier, but he was so frightened he was sent to prison.
Where did he obtain the other license, love, do you know? We'll find out soon enough, love, that you'd help his situation by saving us time.
My maiden name is Symes. I have a brother living in Australia, the same age as Peter.
How long's your brother been out in Australia?
Must be close on 10 years now. When Peter had his license taken away last year...
He applied for another in your brother's name?
Yes. He took the test and passed first time. Everything was fine until he was stopped for speeding the other day. He thought it would be safer to produce his documents here instead of Bow Road Police Station. He's too well known down there, you see.
Well, thanks for coming in, Mrs. Farmer. Is your sister-in-law on the phone?
Yes.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do now. I'll sit on this for an hour. If your husband walks in here under his own steam, it'll look a lot better when he comes up in court.
Sergeant.
1 hour, mind.
You're great softy.
What the bloody hell? Sierra Oscar from DS Roach. Are you
Sierra Oscar from Mike Dashwood, receiving.
Sierra Oscar.
All right, I'll be with you in a minute.
Right, sir.
Sarge, DS Roach and Mike Dashwood both
wanted
it.
Sarge, Hector's in the yard.
You what? Oh, yeah, yeah.
Sergeant Cryer. Oi! Come on, get a bloody thing off!
All right, Chief, don't lose your rag.
Sorry, Ted. Please, go ahead.
Listen, Bob, very carefully. We're on an oboe job at Queen's Parade and bloody red flatfoots are about to blow the whole game. Now, please make contact with them and pull them out. Over.
Oboe job? Queen's Parade? Hold on, Ted. I'll come straight back to you. Get me Carver and Littleton quickly.
Sorry, Sarge. PR units are still US.
Oh, damn the bloody things.
They took them on the off charts, but we've had no joy all day.
Right. Inform Sergeant Roach of the situation. Instruct him to take whatever measures he thinks fit. I'll be up in the CID. I'll give them a bloody oboe job.
Yes, sir, can I... Oh, Mr. Farmer.
I've come to give myself up.
Sarge.
Afternoon, Mr. Farmer. I've been expecting you. PC Smith, take the gentleman up to the charge room, will you? I'll be along shortly.
Right, Sarge.
Excuse me!
What is the problem?
We'll get...
Come on, you two.
Come on,
what's
wrong?
Come on, out of it.
Now, listen, if you seem fit not to put us into the picture, these kind of cops
has messed this up, Robert. They've been helped to pay.
Bloody hell!
Us messing up.
Look,
now, look here,
one more day, that's all I need. Just
look,
one
Inspector,
more day.
If you choose not to.
Go ahead, Ted. Sorry, Ted.
Tell me, Sergeant Roach, quickly.
He's on the air now, sir.
Please inform Detective Inspector Galloway that due to circumstances beyond our control, we have been forced to move in and take two suspects into custody. Over.
What's the situation on site now, Ted?
Yes, sir.
Straight up, the chicken.
Yes, yes, sir. Like two suspects and not much else, sir. Unless you count some new shelving, some naff plastering and a built-in cupboard, sir.
Wonderful. Bloody wonderful. Right. When they bring the suspects back, I want to see Roach up in my office, right? Sharp.
Well, if I read the tea leaves, the only thing he'll get out of those two is a dodgy tax disc.
Bob, we'll have to have a word again. They're getting slack. Looks like a flaming pigsty.
It's been a bit pushed today, Sarge.
All the more reason for keeping organised.
Right. I'm off to get a pint. I've had enough of this place. Make sure Ted Roach gets that message, will you, love?
Okay.
Another 12 and a half minutes before Alec comes on.
Yeah, that's right. I'll see you.
Blimey. Bob!
He's gone, Sarge.
I just don't believe it. One more day. Just one more day, and we would have had him.
I don't think so. Looks like your snout gave you a bummer.
No chance. What do you take me for? Any old you and Dashwood let a pair of bloody wooden tops step in and blow it? I just don't believe that.
It was your cock-up, sir. Nobody else's. You run around shouting and screaming your head off. Just who the bloody hell do you think you are?
I'm your governor. That's who I am.
Oh, is that a fact? Well, let me tell you something, governor.
It's about time you learned a few home truths.
One more word from you, Sergeant, and I'll have you on a report.
I don't give a monkey's what you have me on anymore, sir. You have me up on whatever you like. You cocked up. Not me, not Mike, and certainly not the boys in uniform. You.
Right, that's it!
And you know something? You used to be a good copper. Bit on the flash side, but good. Now you're just a loud-mouthed bully boy who stamps his feet when he doesn't get what he wants. You don't have a monopoly on being right, sir, whatever your rank.
Look, listen, Ted. All I'm saying is don't do anything hasty. Just go home and sleep on it.
Yeah, well, it may not be down to me anyway.
And Roy is not like that. He'll cool down.
Do you reckon? Yeah, well, I can't guarantee I will.
Of course you will, because what's the alternative? The
That bank job was a bit cheeky, wasn't it?
What bank?
Glasscock Street. It's been on the news.
Glasscock Street?
Reckon they must have been down there all weekend.
First I've heard of it.
Only dug under the road, didn't they? Straight up the sewer, right into the vault.
I knew it. I told them his snout sold him one.
Oh, I doubt it, Ted. Glasscock Street's not even on our ground.
Afternoon, Roy. Dropped a clanger, has he? What can I get for you, love?
Scotch, please. And whatever they're having.
And the landlady?
Yeah, of course.
I'm only kidding. Same again.
Yeah, cheers. Haven't been that bad, have I?
Yes.
Worse. Cheers, Roy.
Right then. I'll see you later back at the Nick tent. We'll go for everything we got. Together. Okay?
Yeah, okay. Go off.
I'll see you.
Yeah, see you, Roy.